Welcome to Ask Hytrol. Today we're going to discuss how to properly tension and track a belt on an ABEZ. Before attempting to physically track the belt, follow these tracking inspection steps. Follow proper lockout tagout procedures. Make sure the conveyor is level across the width and length of the unit. Adjust the supports as necessary. The unit must be square to properly track the belt. Check to make sure the drive pulley, tail pulley, snub idler, and all return idlers are square with the conveyor bed. Make sure the belt has been properly threaded through the conveyor. Make sure the belt lacing has been installed correctly and that the edges of both ends of the belt are in line with each other. Following proper lockout tagout procedures, you can adjust the belt's tension with either the take-up pulley or tail pulley. Keep the pulley square by moving both take-up bolts an equal amount. You need to maintain enough tension so the drive pulley will not slip when carrying the heaviest product. Excessive slippage will reduce the belt's life and damage the drive pulley lagging. So do not apply more tension than what's needed. Overtension will cause extra wear to the belt and bearings and will require extra power from the drive. As a belt under model, the rollers will be rolling one way with the belt running the opposite direction. If the belt is drifting toward one specific side, move the snub idler nearest the discharge end on the opposite side toward the end feed end of the conveyor. Please note that minor belt tracking adjustments should be made 1/8 of an inch at a time. Give the belt adequate time to react to the adjustments. It may take several complete revolutions around the conveyor for the belt to begin tracking properly on long, slow conveyor lines. If the belt continues tracking improperly, redo the tracking inspection steps and make corrections as necessary. You have now tensioned and tracked a belt on an ABEZ. For more maintenance tips, contact your Hytrol Solutions provider.